Hello there. I'm from England, the Medway Fellowship, about an hour from London and an hour from Dover, so at the south of England. My testimony goes back to when I was 17. My sister came to the fellowship. She had two little boys and a husband, and I thought it was all right for her. But God wasn't really in my plan. I just wanted to go out and do what all my friends were doing. So I kind of avoided her for about 5 years. And then when I needed somewhere to stay, I called on her and asked if I could stay with her. And she said, yep, you can stay with me. And I said, but I don't want you Bible bashing me. And I can't remember what her reply was. But I went there and I just witnessed... everything they did was to do with the church, and they seemed to be happy with that, whereas being brought up as Catholics, we used to say we were going to Mass and then go off to the park, and then when I was 15, I stopped going. But then the Gulf War came to a peak. It was 1991. And I could just see World War on the telly. You know, there were people bombing each other and it was on the news all the time. And I began to get really afraid of you know, the end of the world. And I also, you know, getting ready for work, I would just think, well, what's the point? You know, Saddam Hussein's going to blow us all up. And, I really did have a fear there of what I was seeing in the newspapers and on the telly. And I remember going into my sister's room one day and she had three Bibles open on the bed watching the telly, and I could see that she knew something about it that I didn't. So I kind of asked her what she thought about it all, and she said in so many words, if you're right with God, you've got nothing to be afraid of. And that made me think, well, am I right with God? I didn't know. So then I began to ask more and more questions, and they were all answered from their experience or from the Bible. And I got to a point where I just thought, well, I've just got to see if what she's telling me is true. I understood that I needed to be baptized. She did talk about the Holy Spirit, but it kind of went over my head. I didn't really get that bit. I just had to know whether it was true or not. So one day I got baptized by full immersion in water, and that day also I received the Holy Spirit and spoke in tongues for the first time. And that's when things began to change. And the first thing I noticed was that I felt safe. I felt like I was in a little bubble. My childhood was a bit broken and a bit crazy, and I was a very insecure person. I used to tell lies, I used to say anything to get myself out of trouble, and they were the first things that I noticed, was that I felt safe. And even now when I look at the news and I see the hideous things that are going on in the world, I have a compassion, but I also know that God has he's going to let man do what he wants for a time, and he's going to come back and tidy it all up. And when he does come back, I just want to be pleased to see him.